Well, here we are. Well, I had a nice little surprise tonight. I finished my day's labors, joyful labors. Just doing whatever it is I like to do. But I was just sitting there and I was running out of videos to watch, man. I just been writing a book today. It's all over YouTube. You just check my Google page and you'll see the book that I wrote today. But so I finished writing my book and watching different videos, and today's been a music video day. And I was thinking to myself, dang, I still feel like watching some videos, man. Let me go through my subscriptions, you know, because nobody posted any new stuff here lately, so I'm just going through it, and it's like, who haven't I seen in a while here? Oh, Holford. I go there to Holford, and he was trying out some Christian stuff, or some Christmas songs. Christmas, you know. And, I was delightfully surprised, you know, and just kind of like, it was all just the right universal timing. And, because I need something to listen to. I was looking for something to listen to. And it was something that was kind of fresh, you know. So I was making some food on oatmeal on the stove and listening to it. And the thing that stood out to me was Rob's voice. Yeah, Rob. Yeah. It was a new range. It was a new range. Fresh, you know. Fresh new range. Okay, now I gotta keep myself centered. Keep the walls going. Now, I don't want to get locked in thought, because I said fresh new range. Thought comes by in the head saying, oh, you want to be careful what you say, Rob might get offended. So, I got to polarize that thought and say, no, he's not. He won't get offended. Put my thoughts on it. Send my thoughts across the earth to wherever he's at. Telepath. Communicate with him. See? There. Yeah. He's laughing right now. He's smiling. See, he's happy. So that's good. I don't want to get myself locked into the fears of, you know, you got to be careful. You don't want to say the wrong thing, you know. Polarize that thought. Well, hi, Tiny. You know? Come here. Come here. Come here. There you go. Get a good girl. Get a good girl. There you go. Come here. Now, Tiny, I've been pushing Tiny away lately because she's been smothering me too much when I sit up here on the bed. I'm eating my food, and she just constantly. I gotta train her to learn how to keep her distance when I'm feeling smothered. You know, it's not all the time. You know, it's just sometimes I'm not in the mood to have her smother me when I'm eating my food. There you go. Here, I give you a little brushing. Might as well have you a little brush. There you go. Come here. There you go. Keep myself centered now. That's been my theme of the day, is of the whole week, is keeping myself centered. And that's, I do that by just keeping my eye, observing the thoughts, and keeping my peripheral vision on the surroundings that are around me. Now, I was introduced to this technique when I was about, careful with your claws, Tiny. Relax. Works. I've got to brush her all the time because the fleas like to chomp on her, especially. Because I got to get all the chomper, and she starts to scab up on the back down here, so I got to constantly keep her clean to fleas. Until such time as I can put my thoughts on it and get these fleas and her back healed. Relax. Alright, there you go. Yep, she had a flea on her. Hold on, I'll be back. So I've been keeping myself, that's been the theme lately, is keep myself centered. So I listened to Rob, I listened to your songs all in different orders, just as I felt led to lead to listen to them. So all the songs were mellow. One of the songs was missing. That was a spirit song, but spirit's invisible anyway, so. But for the most part, I'm still doing discoveries on bringing the spirit to visibility. I was listening to Rob's songs in different orders on his Christmas songs, and I finally did the last one. I think it was, pretty sure it was the Three Kings one. And after listening to song after song of nice, mellow, relaxed, all of a sudden the last song, we just picked it all up with a speedster, with a speedy intro. And the solo was somewhat arpeggiated melodically and kind of punchy on the second phrase of the solo, like Glenn Tipton style. And like on either Defenders of the Faith era punchiness, one of the solos he does, it reminded me of it. But it was cool. I had a fun time on that song, making comments, because I was able to get creative with my words. I just like to throw words out there, and then I'll go back and I'll edit everything and make it how I'm really feeling, you know, and try to pinpoint exactly as best I can. But at the same time, to feel free and just put it out there, no matter how it lands, and then let it take its own shape. And, that was cool. Now, I learned that Rob Halford, or I learned from you, Rob, that, Satchel played with guitar with you. Now, I like Satchel, his guitar playing, and he's very creative. And I was watching church show today, Joel Osteen. I think he's got like the biggest church. One of the biggest churches, but it's pretty much a law of attraction church. And but anyway, he has the same bone facial structures in his face as Satchel, the way his nose is shaped, and just the way his mouth and his teeth are shaped. And So they probably come from the same bloodline, physically structured. But now getting back to the law of attraction and the churches, of course, I had stopped being involved with the Trinity Broadcasting Network Holy Roller Church about early 2000, and because of a book that I read called The Gospel Solution, and it gave a whole different perspective on Jesus's words, his parables, and so I went on like a 10-year study, and it led me away from the faith movement. But after my 10-year study, toward the end of my studies, I was introduced to Private Maritime Law by Winston Strout and various other teachers. But then I learned how to. My mom had Winston Strout videos, and she finally, or I was finally interested in listening to them after the bank started coming after me. And she was kind of always saying, "No, you need to put in a lien." I didn't understand the lien yet. So when she gave me the videos, she just happened to have the Commercial Lien single DVD, and I got to listen to Winston Strout explain what the Commercial Lien's about. And then my eyes were finally open. It's like, ah, because that was my missing piece of the puzzle in all the paperwork that I did. And so in his seminars, he said, "Don't just stop learning about private maritime law." He says, "All private maritime law is patterned after natural law." So I was like, So when I decided to have my power and water cut off, I forced myself to go live out in the backyard, and I just sat in the backyard and just pondered nature. I had took some cannabis too, that helped me. And all of a sudden, my mom, I was making visits to my mom. My mom started buying all kinds of books on all the history of mankind, everything she could get, because Winston was recommended, don't just stop with your studies. Once she got involved with it and started understanding private maritime law, she wanted to know everything about the world. And she's been a big book reader on all kinds of every subjects, everything you can think of anyway. So, and I just finally realized that. But she started telling me, she says, Freemasonry is actually good, and I had saw it as evil. And so finally one day in the backyard by myself, I just, after listening to her, I was like getting clues that, damn, maybe there is something to this. So in the backyard, I just raised my hands, my spirit up to God, and I says, "Okay, it's gotten to the point now where I can't bear it anymore. I'm going to look into this." I said, "Teach me. If there's something to this, teach me." And just shit, didn't take very long, man. And I was like, "Whoa, the Illuminati, the ancient secrets of the Illuminati, and all their history, and holy smoke, the law of attraction." And I see how the law of attraction, the ancients infiltrated the church, known as, and they did it through the faith movement. Yeah, that's why. Now I understand why the media and the fundamental church always persecuted the Holy Roller churches, because they say, oh, they just want your money, they just want your money, they spend money and buy themselves extravagant stuff and all that. And I understood that that's a natural law. Wherever you channel your thoughts toward, and it's a law of giving and receiving. It's universal law, I found out actually too. And it's yeah, it's all good. But even so, bringing it up to date, why I brought up the church thing was because I've been getting into it again now and studying, seeing what they're all about. And I can see that within them, there's some of them that know what's really going on, and for the sake of not causing any riots and rocking the boat in the system and with the people who want to have been trained to hear a certain thing, they only reveal so much information to them. But then there's others who kind of like half know what's going on, so. And that just goes along with realizing all organizations have people that are always at different levels of learning. And so I realize it's like, so I'm, getting into it now. The Holy Roller Trinity Broadcasting, listening to the teachers again, and I'm seeing how the law of attraction is the driving force behind the mind shift that we have. And it's all patterned after universal law. So I studied the Illuminati, some of their history, some of their writ, some of their books, and it just all makes sense to me. This is all universal law based on cause and effect, called thought and manifestation. And thought is our cerebrum, our upper brain. It represents the Holy of Holies that's represented in the Bible. And the animal brain is the lower brain, which is represents the ego, and where the ego is houses ego control. Nothing wrong with ego, but ego control is violent, and that's where terrorism comes from. So yeah, I'm just like, holy smoke, I see how everything, the universe works now. I see how life works. It's all powered by thought, and thought manifests these bodies that we got, and how it ties in with the legal codes that we're under, and how we can get ourselves out from under legal codes, and how legal codes actually keep limit people's lives so that they die. And when you sign yourself out of Prison Planet by way of security agreement and commercial lien, and you have an understanding of what it really is in all aspects, then you realize, oh shoot, this is the ticket to eternal life. Just like, and that we're all one big family on Earth, man. We're all one world order. We're one. And there ain't no need to judge, point fingers, and everybody gets to do their own thing, all for the sake of peace. Now, just as in our own bodies, if we have diseased and cells in our body, viruses that are attacking live cells, then we want to rehabilitate those viruses and cells so that they're healthy, so they don't attack other cells. So the law of correspondence, which is known through the phrase as above, so below, as it is in the body, so it is in our body of people, which is, and terrorist acts are just cells that need rehabilitation, or people that need rehabilitation. So some people call them Al Qaeda and ISIL or ISIS, and I don't like to call them terrorists. I like to call them potential princes of peace. So, because that's what we all are. We're all potential princes of peace. We're just at different levels. Some are more destructive. Some are at the destructive level. Self-injurious. And when you're know, if when we're in the self-injurious mode of thought, then if we're injuring ourselves, then we end up injuring other people. So, and there's different levels of that too. So, yeah, I see how the world operates now. Everything's like coming so much crystal clear day by day by day by day by day. So what I'm learning to do is to just become, realize that I have my eternal life now. And there's the train horn, Mother Nature's train horn. She always backs me up, man. She's done it so many times, and I've said truth so many times, and my expectations and my desires so many times, and I've learned how to listen to Mother Nature so many times. It's just automatic. It's like boom. Everything is just poof. So I ain't gonna die. In fact, I'm gonna be the first man to live forever, and I hope to bring as many people as I can to that point also. And it's gonna happen. Believe me, it's not just a hope, it's a knowing, and it's a desire that's going to be fulfilled. And, you know, all because of my brain up here. And we're all tied together, all our brains are tied together. All you got to do is use ESP telepathically and just imagine yourself communicating with everybody else. Like right now, I'm communicating with everybody in the world, including you, Rob, and Satchel. Joel Osteen, everybody, Walter Cronkite, even the ones that are dead. I communicate with everybody. I was like, if I can imagine it, it's happening. And no doubt, I don't doubt it. You know, doubt is just sin. It's unbelief. So, yeah. Peacefulness is the way to go, man. And however you want to live your life, you live your life. And, but, you know, it is nice to bring everybody to that point of peace, because it's no fun living with people, living in injury and harm, you know, having someone cut arms off and feet off and heads off and shoot with guns and all that, you know, just in the name of claiming, you know, one way. And I understand that the church, the fundamental church, started all that. And, you know, the extremist Islamics, is what they're called. I call them potential princes of peace now, for the sake of rehabilitation and setting a new era into the ear so they can hear it and say, oh, I'm not a terrorist. I'm a potential prince of peace. So it puts hope in them. So yeah, that's cool, Rob. Listening to your relaxed new voice, or not new voice, but I'm sure you've sang like that to yourself all the time. So, but it's nice hearing it. So that'll be the end of this recording. And I love you, Rob. Love you all. Talk to y'all later. Bye-bye.